ultimate goal of 3D printing is to disconnect having the idea from making the idea, so that you can just have the idea and it doesn't matter what happens in the middle. It doesn't matter how it's made. The idea is eventually you say tea, Earl Grey, hot, and nobody cares what happens in the middle. I mean, it's cool, but you know, in the perfect world, the 3D printer is invisible and you never realize it exists, because you have an idea, you design your idea, you have your physical object. And our job in the world of 3D printing is to make those things come together so that the gap in between is invisible.
The art contributed more to man's progress than any other art. By means of printing, the fund of knowledge accumulated through the ages is available to everyone. Printing is essential to all education. All the other arts rely on it. Business could not function without it, nor could government. Because of the need for printed matter in practically all of man's activities, printing now ranks fourth among the nation's great industries.
Hi, my name is Espen Sivertsen, and I'm the CEO of Type A Machines, and we build 3D printers. We've been doing that since January of 2012. We started out in San Francisco. By the end of last year, we were 18 people in 350 square feet of office space, so a little bit tight. So we moved here to San Leandro, where we have 18 acres of old Ford factory to really expand into. And we've not come alone. We've actually brought with us 10 other 3D printing companies, all startups that are working together to form a tool chain, which hopefully is pretty seamless by the end of it all.
Hi, my name's Andrew. I'm the CTO and founder here at Type A Machines. I bought my first ever 3D printer back in 2009, and then in 2010 I emigrated to the US. And I couldn't work for the first few months, and so I got my kit 3D printer back out of its box and got it working again. And then I started redesigning it, which I did several times, and eventually I designed a machine of my own from scratch. I did a lot of my early prototyping at a hackerspace here in San Francisco called Noisebridge, where I also happened to meet one of the co-founders of the company.
So Type A Machines really started at Noisebridge, which is a hackerspace in San Francisco. And the backstory is both Andrew, our founder and CTO, and I were waiting for our green cards. Basically, our wives got tired of Andrew hacking on his kitchen table, threw him out, and my wife was tired of me sitting around, threw me out. So we ended up hanging around in Noisebridge.
And because of Noisebridge, I was introduced to Tech Shop. I got a membership and I invested money that I'd actually made being paid to do 3D printing in building the first machine of my own design.
So we sort of joined this team and started building 3D printers. And here we are a couple of years later, 27 people and 700 customers.
There are something like over 150 different companies making what can be broadly considered a desktop 3D printer right now. We're certainly one of the more prominent companies, and we're definitely building best machine in its class. But it's a very competitive and very fast moving space.
But we're seeing, you know, our customers are doing everything from 3D printed cookie cutters to two-part resin dividers for aerospace. And what they're doing is they're taking 3D printing and adding like a secondary process, like, you know, making cookies or adding a potted plant or, you know, creating resin bags for aerospace. And then they're basically building a business around that.
We're not selling people a machine so they can build a 3D printer. We're not selling people a machine so they can 3D print. It's so they can 3D print whatever it is they want to make. And it's getting to that end point that they really care about.
A little while ago when we went through our user data, that about 8% of our customer base have started their own company or running their own startup using our 3D printer as a primary tool. And that just blows my mind, because if you look at the statistics, we are actually producing more startups right now than most business schools.
So one of the things that we've learned a lot about building that, there's about 500 of the first machine, is which components really are critical. You learn where does precision matter, but where does consistency matter? And there were entire classes of components where we've just gone to something completely different because we knew we would never get the right product. You know, we've gone to a lot of different suppliers, but there's only two suppliers that we've actually retained between the first generation and the second generation Series 1 without any issues. And one of those suppliers is Boca Bearings.
And so we actually went through quite a few bearing companies before we ended up with Boca Bearings. And the reason we've stuck with them for so long now is because they've been able to not only produce consistent quality in terms of their product, but also they've been super flexible and super accommodating.
One of the things that you want from a supplier, and that any supplier wants to be to their customer, is you want to be the only thing they never worry about. And we have never had to worry about Boca Bearings as a supplier.
You know, we went from doing, you know, less than 2 or 3 machines a month when we started out to 20 machines a week at the moment, and we're scaling rapidly. I think the other thing as well is just like, we like them as people. You know, we're actually, it's a big deal. Like, you actually want to be working on a day-to-day basis with people that you actually like.
You know, you go to the shelf and you take the bearings out of the box that says Boca Bearings, and they work. And it sounds like a tiny, tiny thing, but that is so valuable. Is we buy the components, we get the components that we want in a timely manner, and they are what we ordered, and they work. And many people say, oh, hardware is difficult, or why is hardware difficult? And it's because getting what you want, when you want it, and having it be consistent and reliable is surprisingly difficult.
On the manufacturing side, this is a new product, it's a new technology, and as anyone in the manufacturing industry will tell you, what can go wrong will go wrong. And so having a flexible supplier has always been really important for us, and someone who can quickly, you know, just get what we're trying to do. And I think that's the feeling that we get from them as well. Like, for us, you know, it's not about what we're doing, it's about what our customers need at the end of the day. And we get the same sense of service from Boca Bearings as well. You know, we've been concerned about, you know, security and safety and stuff. We've done a lot on that. And the reason for that is because we're working in so many different environments. And the school environment is a really important one. What we see is, you know, the moment you give the kids the tools to create, something just triggers in their brain. And they go from, you know, thinking about not trying to make mistakes to exploring and throwing themselves into it.
People say, oh yeah, we should put 3D printers in education. No. We have to put 3D printers in education. It is going to be the most transformative tool in a decade for education. You're going to have an entire generation that discovers engineering that wouldn't have before.
We need to move kids from the mindset of being, and from an education system in which we create good employees, to an education system in which we create good entrepreneurs.
Suddenly you can hand somebody a 3D printer, and the generation that grows up knowing how to use an iPad instinctively suddenly has a tool where they can use it to make anything. Overall, it's what the Industrial Revolution has been about, shaping the world to be what we want it to be. And 3D printers are just a particularly good tool at chopping out that huge bit of the world in between, so you can have your idea and then you can have your thing. But until we get there, 3D printers and any kind of technology like it is a tool to get the world to be closer to what we imagine it should be.